డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయ విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం.
వెల్కమ్ టు ది వీడియో లెసన్ ఆఫ్ డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ ఫర్ ది బెనిఫిట్ ఆఫ్ ఎంఏ మ్యాథ్స్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ పబ్లిక్ రిలేషన్ స్టూడెంట్స్. టుడేస్ టాపిక్ ఈజ్ హౌస్ జర్నల్స్ యాజ్ టూల్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇంటర్నల్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ రైటింగ్ ఫర్ ది హౌస్ జర్నల్స్. మై డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, దిస్ టాపిక్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ చోజన్ ఫ్రమ్ యువర్ కోర్స్ బుక్ Editing and Production of Publications. This topic is part of your syllabus. Coming to the topic, printed word is not only most effective but also potent medium of communication to reach especially literate population. It influences them, the mindset is influenced by the printed media. An added advantage of print media is it is not only portable but it is also you can preserve it permanently and refer whenever you want it. That is the advantage of print media. This print media can be classified from the point of view of public relations into two categories. The first category is newspapers, magazines, journals through which public relations practitioners communicate to the target audience. That is the first category. The second category is corporate publications. Every organization brings out different types of publications to influence, to inform, to educate and motivate the stakeholders, internal stakeholders and external stakeholders. The corporate publications include house journals, annual reports, corporate profiles, diaries, calendars and product catalogs. So among all these things, you see, house journals have its own their own role to play. It is because public relations starts with internal communication. Public relations starts with the employees' relations. Once you educate the employees, they in turn not only provide services to the customers but also build image of the organization. Against this background, house journal as a tool of internal communication plays a very significant role in the practice of public relations. Today, we have a distinguished scholar in printing technology, Sri D. Nagarjuna, who has come to our studios to enlighten on the topic house journals as tools of internal communication, writing for the house journals. Welcome to the studios, Nagarjuna Garu. At the outset, I would like to request you, for the benefit of my students, how do you define a house journal? That is the beginning of our subject.
Thank you, sir. Any company which brings out a publication for the benefit of its employees, if it is internal, or for the benefit of its customers, if it is outside, just I am citing an example, any publication that is brought out on behalf of the company or by the company, we can call that as house journal. It is also referred very commonly with different nomenclature. Many people call it as in-house magazine, they call it as a shop paper, they call it as a plant paper also, plant any magazine that comes out out of the company, it is called as a house journal. It is called in-house.
No, because you see why it is house. See, employees spend about 12 hours
Yes, sir.
In the company. That is under second house of the employees.
Yes.
So the name itself indicates. See, house means it's a company.
Company's
journal.
Company.
That is the
yes.
How I think they have named it as
yes,
house journal.
House journal. Yes, sir. And the function of this, the main function of this house journal is to bring out a channel of communication between the management and the employees.
Employees.
So they communicate with the employees regarding everything that happens in the company. If there is something which is going to happen in future also, any new developments or anything related to employees, their families, their children. It is some kind of a motivation to the employees, and that is the reason, that is the major function of house journal,
to make communicate them as partners
and
of
also
the company.
To give them a sense of belonging to the company.
Yes.
The house journal makes the employees, gives the employees and their families a sense of pride of belonging to such an organization, so that they are able to also communicate, if they have anything also to communicate, they have to communicate. They can communicate, there is a free flow of information between the management and the employees through this important tool of communication, which is house journals.
Another important function is from the employees to the management.
Yes, sir. From the employees to the management. It's a two-way process.
Yes,
actually.
Employees also could express.
Yes, sir.
In this way,
yeah.
The management comes to know the reactions of the employees towards their policies. If necessary, they can comment. Any other function you want to discuss?
The management gets a very good feedback, as a matter of the free and frank feedback, which they may not get through formal meetings or the get-together that they have. But this medium of communication, this house journal, will make them free to express themselves.
They can give suggestions.
Suggestions also, they can express freely. They can come forward and tell so and so. So that they are also assured that nothing will be, you know, against them actually.
You see, for example, why don't you explain about this?
Yes, sir.
This is the first newsletter of
Open
University. Dr. Ambedkar
Open University has brings out a newsletter periodically. This is also as good as an in-house publication, and normally brought out for the internal circulation
as well as
the external circulation.
Students,
also
their parents,
yes,
they
yes,
can
parents
also.
Also to the well-wishers, to the others, people who patronize, and this is one of the medium of actually communicating with everyone to tell about what is happening in the organization.
So similarly, every organization,
for
example, if I remember correct, you see Andhra Bank brings us Magic Card something.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, State Bank of India,
yes,
has a house magazine.
Yes, sir.
State Bank of Hyderabad,
yes,
almost every Singareni Collieries. Every organization brings out a
yes,
journal, but you see, these house journals categorized into three.
Yes, sir.
One is
the internal,
exclusively for the
internal house journal.
Employees,
yeah,
that is called internal publics. Another is
external.
For example, you see, some magazine they bring out only for
external.
Dealers,
sure.
Like that, you see, they
yes.
bring out. Third is
Combination of both.
Both.
The internal.
So the house journals may be three types of house journal. Ultimately, to inform, to educate, motivate the stakeholders in the process of the company's activities. Now, coming from this, you see, writing for the journal is another subject that we have to discuss.
Yes.
See, it is said, writing is the rock bottom of public relations.
Yes.
Practice.
Yes.
And writing is to inform. Public relations writing is to inform, not to influence with the language.
Okay.
Against this background, what is your suggestion about the writing for house journals?
This plays a very crucial role, sir. What is written constitutes the success of what actually the reader is trying to understand. A good writer will write it in a very simple manner, very short and a lucid style. He will maintain a style of writing. He will not try to show off his prowess or his own skills of his knowing the language.
Yes.
He should step into the shoes of the reader.
Reader, that's
and
right.
Then make the reader understand in the easiest manner possible. And the most important thing that the writer should keep in mind is that the readers are from a wide cross-section of audience. There can be people who can be matriculates, graduates or postgraduates among the target audience of say an internal house journal. Employees are there, employees, spouses are there, children are also there. So the style of writing should be in such a way that it is able to cater to the assimilation of the actual meaning of what you want to convey by one and all. This is the most important thing that we have to keep in mind. Secondly, we should not ignore, even though they look very small and ignorable, they are not, such as spelling, such as punctuation.
So they should be careful about the grammar.
Such as grammar. Uh-huh. They have to be very, very careful about these things, because they are not simply communicating. They are also actually spreading the language in a way. They are able to, in fact, learn English through this, if it is English or any other language through which the journal is brought out. They are able to understand actually what is the written communication. It should be very, it should be to the point also. And if they are writing any points in that, and those points should be in a logical sequence. It should come one after the other. There should not be any confusion between this. So, a writer keeps in mind the free flow of information from the beginning till the end.
See, in essence, you see, the writer of the house journal,
yes, sir,
should keep the background of the readers,
readers,
their literary background,
yes,
their social background,
yes,
economic background.
Yes, correct, sir.
Based on that,
he should write.
So that is, they can understand.
Yes, yes.
That should be the, any other point you want to say?
Well, actually, normally it is better to write in active voice than passive
voice.
Voice gives straightforward information. Passive voice is slightly beating around the bush.
Active voice is straightly, you are giving information,
straight information. That is one thing, sir.
Active voice.
And try to avoid these compound sentences, complex sentences. Sentence should not be more than normally 5 to 7 or 8 words, normally, not more than that. And when they are writing, they should not use jargon, sir.
Jargon. Should not use.
You see, if, for example, I will tell you one word, prima facie. Why, it is it's a legal term, maybe an average fellow
may
understand.
May not understand.
If it is someone says he's got red-handed, there is a foolproof evidence. Is better than prema facie. Prema facie means,
you mean to say jargon, they should avoid.
Yeah, avoid to the extent possible, because we should not make the reader to refer a dictionary, distract
again,
him from reading.
Yes, to read.
You should read it, understand and go ahead with that.
Good.
We are interrupting him by using some jargon. So he goes again in the jargon, in the process of searching for the jargon and getting the meaning, he may actually miss the actual points in the message also, sir. So, wherever possible, jargons act as speed breakers actually.
I see.
They act as speed breakers.
Speed breakers.
Wherever possible, we can avoid them.
Avoid them.
Or even if it is there, such a jargon which is familiarly known to one and all, it's okay, sir. Otherwise, we can try to our best to avoid this technical jargon. Where it's unavoidable, we'll use it. That's the thing.
I think in writing for house journals,
yes, sir,
the writer should take care of some case studies, achievements.
Yes.
Achievements of an organization,
yes,
should be codified as a case study,
yes,
and write. Then only you see it will be useful to the readers to understand what the organization,
yes,
has done. After writing for the media, I think you see the success of house journal depends on the contents,
yes,
that are used in the house journal. What could be a typical type of content of house,
yes,
journal?
Strictly speaking, sir, there is no hard and fast rule for the contents, number one.
Yes.
But by and large, if you go through most of the well-known or well-established house journals from companies which have a very long standing and which are historically pretty well-known, you will find that they all are having some common items in a,
yes,
house journal.
For example, you see, chairman's
desk.
Like
a message from the chairman's,
yes,
desk. Because the chairman, the top person, is communicating with everyone down the ladder, even to the last security guard of the organization also. So, chairman's message. Then an editorial will tell what exactly is,
yes,
about this house journal. What are we going to discuss about this house journal? What is the speciality of this issue? What are all the points we are going to discuss in this issue? Is there anything that is special in this issue? Any development in this issue? So these things are all, they all come in editorial. Then write-ups from employees as well as from the management. Employees can give
from
their
management
views.
Side, you see,
yes, sir.
The key achievements of the organization,
yes.
I think, could be highlighted.
Yeah, mainly they can highlight the achievements of the organization. They can also give maybe the future plans of the organization. If they are going to update some machinery, they can inform about that. If they are going to be there going to be some HR improvement, they can inform in that. So likewise, these contents go from management to employees, their spouses, their children, and sometimes you can also give all about the promotions, transfers,
welfare,
retirements,
activities.
Welfare activities. Yes. Your CSR, corporate social responsibility.
Good.
Then obituaries to the deceased staff.
Good. Retirements.
Retirement. These are all the small things but very sensitive and give a sense of attachment to the organization from the employees. Maybe some paintings from the children. So children have got some merit. Somebody has got a good rank, state rank. You are publishing it so that the other employees also get motivated.
Motivated.
From the welfare point of view it is. This is from the welfare point of view. So the house journal is a blend of so many items that it suddenly becomes, as you said very rightly in the beginning, that it is more a house, a family,
yes, family.
Rather than some,
yes,
kind of an
organization. That is why its name.
Yes,
name
sir.
Itself
very rightly
indicates house
that.
Journal.
Yes.
Your house means your company. Where you spend about 12,
yes,
13 hours,
that's
out of 24 hours you spend. That's why it is termed as a house for the employees.
So this journal also links the employees with their families.
Families, yes.
Normally employee may not talk anything about his work. He may just give the house journal. That itself is self-explanatory for the family to understand about the good things their people are doing in the organization. They will be proud that, oh, my person is doing this. He is doing so and so,
yes,
in this organization. They will be proud of that.
I know, I still remember.
Yes, sir.
When I was working in APSRTC, I highlighted the life of a driver.
Yes.
The life of a driver and entire life. That actually, you see, inspired other drivers.
Obviously.
So, the house journal purpose is that one.
Yes.
You should highlight the employees.
Yes.
And we used to cover every month, you see,
yes,
one operation of the depot.
Yes, yes.
Depot.
Yes.
Where employees are involved.
Yes.
So, that's why, you see, writing should take it. Another function of the house journal is to exploit literary talent of the employees. So,
yes,
you can also expect poems, short stories from the employees to be published.
Jokes
in the
or anything,
house journals. Now, let us coming to this, you see,
yes, sir,
the production techniques,
yes, sir,
about the layout to designing.
Yes.
What is your view about the most of the students, you see,
mm-hmm,
are afraid of writing answers,
mm-hmm,
printing and production. What are the production techniques?
Actually, this is a very easy thing to understand, is that the house journal consists of two things, text and illustrations.
Yes, photographs.
Photographs
and
other things. An illustration is equal to 1,000 words.
Mm.
The easiest way for him, the production techniques involve nothing but text and illustrations. Take the best text and the relevant text, edit it properly, take the illustration, edit the illustration if necessary, and use the text and illustration as long as they are relevant. I would recommend that no illustration is better than an irrelevant illustration or a bad illustration.
I see.
So, we let us not use illustration for the sake of illustration, just because I said illustration equal to 1,000 words. What is essential is a proper blend of text and illustration will be very good. But the present day trend nowadays is that the readers want very little to read. They want to understand more very quickly with less reading. That is the reason illustrations have come to play a very important role.
Right.
And that is the main thing nowadays.
That's
it's right. A color war everywhere.
One picture is worth
1,000
words.
That's the thing.
One picture,
yes,
is worth 1,000.
That's the thing.
So, more pictures,
yes,
less words.
And normally it takes pre-press, press and post-printing, anything. As far as PRO is concerned, he should not worry about printing and post-printing. That is not his job. But pre-press means before it goes to the press.
pre-press.
Everything in the house journal should be decided up front.
Designing, cover page, everything.
If any intervention after the pre-press stage, it will be prohibitively expensive and counterproductive.
It is not in easy hands.
This is the biggest problem often the PRO faces, and that is why he is afraid of production of house journal.
So that is the finally printing is taken care of by the printing press.
Printing press, sir.
And the what is the role of PRO?
PRO, sir, role is managerial role. His responsibility ends with at pre-press stage. Once pre-press is ready, he is relieved in a way.
So the major role of a public relations officer. Is to take care of pre-press.
Pre-press, yes,
pre-press.
Sir. Pre-press.
They are designing everything, editing, everything is done.
That should be ensured actually.
So thank you very much,
thank you, sir. Thank you
Nagarjuna garu for explaining about the house journals to our students. Most of the students, they don't answer two questions. One, production techniques and the printing process, they don't answer. My submission is, I give three suggestions to you. One is, you read the course material carefully,
yes,
and you underline important points there only.
Yes.
You can remember at the time of the examination. First, read the course material. Reading is learning. If you don't read, you don't learn anything. Second is, either you can consult the Nagarjuna, Sri D. Nagarjuna, or go to any company, State Bank of Hyderabad, State Bank of India. If you go, definitely they will give you their corporate publication. Go through, interact with them, you will gain some idea. Finally, visit a printing press,
yes,
as Mr. Nagarjuna said, pre-press and printing, press all easy. Then if you follow these three things, I think you see, you will be thorough in your examination. The course being editing and production of our corporate publication. Once again, I thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Nagarjuna, for coming and explaining.
Thank you, sir.
To our students. Right. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Right.
మా కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియచేయండి. మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియచేయవలసిన మా చిరునామా డైరెక్టర్ ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్ డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్ రోడ్ నంబర్ 46 జూబ్లీ హిల్స్ హైదరాబాద్ 500